Hi, and welcome back again to another tutorial on using IRIV PiControl with Node-RED. In this tutorial, we will see how we can monitor the readings of the power meter using Node-RED. In this tutorial, I'm using IRIV PiControl power supply, ADL200 power meter relay, and an AC plug. Before we proceed, please be careful with the AC power. It can be dangerous if not handled correctly. Make sure to turn off any power supply before doing the wiring. Start by powering up the power supply using AC source. Connect the power supply to the IRIV PiControl. Power up the power meter using the AC source. Connect the live and neutral wires from your AC power supply to the corresponding L and N terminals on the power meter. Connect the N terminal of the power meter to the N terminal of the load. For the L terminal, it should be connected to one side of the relay, while the other side of the relay connects to the L terminal of the load. Connect terminals 21 and 22 to the RS485 pins on the IRIV. Connect one end of the relay to the power supply. Connect the other end of the relay to the DO0 pin on the IRIV. To start on Node-RED, first we need to install Modbus node. You can do this using the Node-RED palette manager. Look for these Modbus nodes. We will start by dragging an inject node onto the flow. Open its properties and set repeat to interval every 1 second. Next, drag and drop Modbus getter node and open its properties window. The first setting we have here is unit ID. This identifies the Modbus device we are communicating with. Navigate through your power meter settings to locate the unit ID. In my setup, the unit ID is 2. This is the function code, which specifies the type of Modbus function. Choose function code 3 to read holding registers. Next, we have the address, and this specifies the starting register from which data will be read or written. Type in 0. The quantity specifies the number of registers to be read or written. Type in 14. Next, we have to edit the server settings. Change the server type to serial. For the serial port, click on the search icon, then choose this port. Change the serial type to RTU, and then change the unit ID. Click on add, then close the window. Now drag a function node to get the voltage readings. Open its properties and write this short code. Number 11 in this line to get the voltage readings from the power meter. Next, drag another function node to get the current readings. Open its properties and write this code. Make sure to adjust this number to 12 to get the current readings. We also need one more function node to get the power readings. Write the same code and adjust this number to 13. Now drag 3 debug nodes to display the readings in the debug window. Connect all the nodes together this way. Drag 2 inject nodes so we can control the relay through them. Open the first one and write number 1 to turn on the relay. Open the second one and write number 0 to turn off the relay. Drag GPIO out node and assign it to the relay pin, which is 23. Connect the inject nodes to the relay. Then click deploy. Once we activate the relay, you will notice the readings of the power meter appear in the debug window. Now, let's see how we can display the readings in a dashboard. We will need 3 gauge nodes. Open the first one and adjust these settings for the voltage readings. Open the second one and adjust these settings for the current readings. Open the third one and adjust these settings for the power readings. Lastly, drag a switch node to connect it to the relay. hit deploy. After that, open a new tab in your browser and type in this address to access the dashboard. And there you go. Now you can control the relay and monitor the power meter readings through this Node-RED dashboard. That's all for this tutorial. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more.